Hey y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me today. I am going to be sharing with you a smoothie recipe that will be good for building the blood, getting rid of anemia or low iron, as well as helping with digestion. So this recipe can be eaten any time of the day, and it is filling and will hold you for, you know, 4 or 5 hours, depending on if you drink the whole thing or not. This is a 32-ounce smoothie, at least, depending on how much of the ingredients you use. The recipe will be down in the description box below this video. Okay, so here are the ingredients. The star of the show today is spinach. This is about 3.5 to 4 packed cups of spinach. I like lots of greens in my smoothie. The more greens you have, the better your life is going to be, like for healing. So you don't have to use spinach if you don't like spinach. Some people don't think that spinach is good for helping with anemia, but I'm gonna tell you that whenever I first started working on getting rid of anemia, spinach was really one of the only leafy greens that I could stomach because my taste buds just didn't like greens. So this is what I used, and it worked. The key with using any kind of green to help with anemia is to have something that you're adding to it that has vitamin C in it. And you'll see the vitamin C ingredient in just a second. But this is a lot of greens. So I'm gonna add these greens to my blender here. So I'm gonna put the greens in first. This is basically gonna fill the blender up, really. I'm thinking that this is gonna make one smoothie, but it might be more like two. So I have filled up my blender with those greens. The next ingredient that I'm gonna use is deglet dates. This is going to sweeten this smoothie really well. You can leave these out if you don't like sweet smoothies. I buy these deglet dates by the bag from, what is it, Costco. Costco is where I get these, but you can get them on Amazon. I'll leave a link down in the description box below for either deglet dates. You can also use medjool dates. So if you use medjool dates, don't use more than two because it'll be really sweet. Medjool dates are much bigger than a deglet date. So you see I've got two deglet dates here. That's about the size of one medjool date. So I'm gonna add that to the blender. Next I have some vanilla. This is a vanilla powder. It's plain vanilla. It does not have any other ingredient in it. And so if you use powdered vanilla, you want to make sure it has nothing else in it and that it's a good quality. I will put a link down below with the vanilla powder that I like to put in my smoothies. I think the vanilla powder adds a dimension to the smoothie that is a little bit, it tastes like a dessert almost. So you can either add vanilla powder or you can add vanilla flavoring, but it doesn't taste the same. So vanilla flavoring does make it taste good, but it doesn't taste like using vanilla powder. So I just wanna make that clear. So I'm gonna add the vanilla powder to the smoothie. Next, I've got some cocoa yogurt, and I'm gonna add 2 tablespoons of this. This is gonna help with the gut. It's gonna populate your gut with good gut bacteria, help with those bowel movements, help with constipation and all that good stuff. And this is the only brand of yogurt that I think is good that I've found. All that so delicious stuff that's in the store with all that stuff, I don't recommend it at all. This particular yogurt is nothing but a young coconut, the meat, and the water. That's it. And it's made and it's cultured into yogurt. And that is the only type of yogurt that I recommend that anybody eat. There's just one ingredient in this. It's the coconut and it's water. Okay, I have added the coconut yogurt to the smoothie. It's just shy of 1/4 cup. Next, I have some homemade hemp seed milk that I made in my blender. There is a recipe to make hemp seed milk on this channel. I will link it below in the description box. Just gonna add 2 cups of hemp seed milk. This smoothie is going to be packed. You are not gonna be hungry eating this smoothie. A lot of you say, I eat this way, Chelsea, and you know, I'm still hungry. It's because you're not eating enough. That's why you're hungry. And it's probably withdrawal from food addiction too, from eating the old foods. So now the fruit that I'm adding is I've got 1 frozen banana that I've cut up into chunks. And then I've got 1/2 cup of passion fruit. Passion fruit you can get from Whole Foods, probably some other stores you can get it from. But I'm gonna show you my bag. This is what the bag looks like. And the thing about passion fruit is it is extremely sweet. So you don't wanna put too much in your smoothie because it'll be oversweet. And then I've got 1 cup of pineapple. So the key ingredient in here that's gonna help you absorb the iron that is in the smoothie, in the spinach greens, is the vitamin C that is coming from the fruit, specifically the pineapple. Now, passion fruit may have vitamin C, but I have not looked that up, so I can't guarantee it. I do believe it has vitamin C, but definitely the cup of pineapple is gonna help your body to absorb that iron. The other thing you can do to help with absorbing iron is adding some lemon. Like you can squeeze some juice of a lemon into your smoothie, and that will help your body absorb the iron as well. So I'm gonna add this. Hard to do it with one hand. So if you notice, most of this is greens, but I put those dates in there so it's sweet enough. And I'm gonna blend it and show you what it looks like. It's all well blended. And look, this is delicious green goodness right here. And it smells good too. It's a yummy smoothie. So what do you think of this smoothie? Will you make it? That smoothie is yummy. It smells so good. I hope you try it. And if you try it, let me know. And also down in the description box, let me know what you would like me to make going forward. All right, y'all. Thanks so much. And I will talk to y'all later. Take care. Bye-bye.